Hello, my snaily friends. My name is Lavinia, and welcome. So today we're going to discuss Palmacea diffusa, or Palmacea bergisi, the mystery snail, how they lay their eggs, how to remove their eggs from the wall once they're laid, how to incubate them, and how to hatch them out once the eggs have completed the incubation process. The mystery snail, or Palmacea diffusa, is normally what you would find at your local fish store, will climb up out of the water to lay their eggs, usually overnight or in the wee hours of the morning. Sometimes the sun will rise and the tank lights will come up and they're still laying their clutches. I often feel like I'm intruding on something. So, if you want to try your hand at raising your own mystery snails, here's what you'll do. After you see the clutch, leave it where it is for 24 to 48 hours. And then, if you touch the clutch and it's not sticky or goopy, then you can remove it. You really want to wait till it's firm. Then, applying a little bit of pressure with either your index finger or your thumb, just plop it off. It's really that simple. So, let's practice that. I have a few clutches we can practice on. You just want to apply a little bit of pressure, and there you go. This clutch had been sitting for 2 days. See how easy that came off? Now, after you have your clutch, you want to incubate it. I'll put a link in the corner on how I like to make my mystery snail incubators. I find my method really works very well. You want to put it in your tank and let it incubate and check it every morning. And wait. The incubation stage lasts anywhere from 10 days to 4 weeks. During that time, every day or every other day, you want to check and do maintenance on your incubator. This includes taking out all pieces of the incubator and putting in new pieces. Except the styrofoam for height. You can use that over and over, but replace the paper towels. Here I'm showing that this paper towel is too wet. You don't want your clutches to get too wet. Sometimes if the clutch falls in the water, the embryos can drown, and also too much water inside the incubator can potentially grow mold, which I have seen happen. Doing maintenance on your incubator is very important. If you don't tend to your incubator, things can sometimes mold, or little critters that you might not think are getting in there can potentially get in.
Some serious foreshadowing.
Yes, I know. By the way, if you're watching this video and you think to yourself, deja vu, I feel like I've seen this before, you have. The powers that be had a little musical problem with my previous version. So we're recording it over again. Luckily, I just used the video and I'm redoing the voiceover.
Enjoy.
Oh my gosh, it's happening. It's happening. Baby snails. Do you see? Do you see how it's a little grayish in color? Oh, it's happening. Look at them.
See how it's a little grayer and almost, I want to say moldier, but it's not moldier. It's just grayer and whiter in color. And you'll actually be able to see the baby snails within each individual cell. You can see here too. Those are all baby snails in there. Okay, pop quiz. Which ones are ready to go in here?
These ones. How exciting. This is exciting. Okay. Here's how they get themselves out without human intervention. They chew their way out of each individual cell. In my opinion, there's a couple different ways you can hatch them out. One, you just want to take the clutch very gently in your hands and gently crumble the clutch into a breeder box. I will put a link above for some baby snail tips and care as well.
You really want to try and not let the clutch hatch within the incubation box. Try and keep an eye on it, like I said, every day. And when it gets that gray-white color and you can see little baby snails within each individual cell, you'll know that
it is time.
This one was only half incubated, which does happen sometimes. Again, you just want to crumble the clutch in between your fingers very gently into the breeder. The other method I like to utilize sometimes of hatching them out is more of a natural way. When the clutch is ready, I take it out of the incubator and place it on a wet piece of styrofoam. I usually take a little pipette and I wet the piece of styrofoam down with tank water. I then put the clutch on the styrofoam and sort of break open a few of the cells.
so that the snails can, on their own time, climb out and go for the water. They can actually smell the water, so there's a few in this one here. Look, they're all confused. Where's the water? That's how they get to it. They smell it and they make a snail conga line straight for it. This method is kind of fun if you have time. It does take time. Each of these time lapses is about 2 hours. In real time, it looks like they don't move, but they are moving.
They just have tiny, tiny little baby mystery snail feet, so they don't move very fast.
I do know of a couple different ways that you can hatch out mystery snail clutches. One of them is leaving the clutch where it lays. In my opinion, in order for this to work, you really need to have perfect tank conditions. You don't want it too wet so that the clutch falls off the wall, but you want it just the right amount of humid so that the incubation stage actually completes. Thanks for being here, everyone. I really appreciate it. Hit that like button if you like the video, and subscribe if you haven't already and you like snail content. And I'll see you in the next one. And don't forget, hug your snails.